and it's, very low in calories. So you're telling me that it's the same thing for, for a female
Woman.
then. You know what it is? I got it. You know what we produce?
What's that?
Emergency.
Okay. All right. See, you don't even need the glass, don't need a cup, don't need no water, boy. Go right to the punani, right there.
You get it
Bam.
straight,
You
and
get
it's
it straight.
potent.
I mean,
Yeah.
right out the tap, right out the tap. I'm serious. Right out the tap. Well, what I did was I hooked it up, and because of my endurance, I did it for about 45 minutes to an hour, which I can go much, much longer.
What? Wait, wait, wait. 45 minutes down there, Monty? That's too
What's something wrong with
long.
that?
What
That
the
is not
fuck?
too long.
45 minutes down there? That's a little bit too
Look,
much.
no, not if you're doing it right. Like,
God,
if
that's
you
a long
trying to, if
time.
you trying to, no. If you trying to speed read and try to haul ass, no, you can't do that. You got to take your time.
I'm trying to
it's
speed,
just like,
read, proceed, and sit on it.
no. Well, we didn't have time for. I mean, we could have, but. She wasn't trying to do that. See, I got to give you a sample. As I've told people before, it's like my love is like whoa. So therefore, I just can't just.
I love that song.
Yeah. See, my love is like whoa. It really is. It comes with an explicit, can you handle it type thing. And a lot of people say yeah, and then they get it, and all of a sudden they become sprung. So. Right now, she's already sprung, and all I did was lick it, basically. So, if I give you my slide technique, once I give you the, as Bernie Mac would say, the dick,
So if you
then,
dick it, then that's it.
yeah. Oh, well, that's it with the tongue. And if I give you the dick, then you already caught up. You know what I'm saying? So. I mean, I don't know. I'm just good at what I do. I'm very, very in tuned and very talented, but I don't advertise it with, I don't give it to everybody. So, she's kind of lucky and
You're
she's a very lucky woman.
crazy, Monty. I love your stories. Thank you so much for calling me in tonight. You know what? I have to play that song just for you. Maya, my love is like whoa. We have to go.
Oh,
You're
I got
crazy.
other songs. I got a soundtrack, so I got to put all that together. But
Yes,
with
please
my
do
schedule,
that.
I'm very busy.
See,
But
baby, I know you done had your share of girls, but I am more than confident you won't ever have to search these
he's
streets for
funny.
affection. I got you.
One, two, three.
What kind of girl you like? I know my looks can be deceiving. Tell me, am I your type? My main goal is to please you. What's on the schedule tonight? Appetite. So tell me, will you come and spend the night?
Monty said it, his tongue is like, whoa. Monty, you're so crazy. I'm so glad you finally called me. You're listening to the show, Dash Radio Discover. And you know what? Since we were on that topic with Monty, if you guys have any special particular techniques that you use, let me know. Let us know. And, you know, maybe you guys can compare notes and see, you know, why you think you're better, you know, than the average guy. What do you do? What do you do differently that makes you better? Tweet me at Elizabeth Meza, or message me on Facebook, or also Dash Radio. We are here. Now I can introduce my guest, Dr. Roya. Welcome to the show. And Dr. Roya is a doctor who does transgender surgeries. Yes. I can't even hear you. Are you? Okay, there.
Yes, there we are.
You got you.
Hello.
Hi. Thank you for coming. I think it's so fascinating, you know, when originally Maria mentioned having you in studio, that's like so fascinating to me. How did you decide to do that type of surgery?
I've been doing cosmetic surgery for over 20 years.
Yeah.
And I think, well, most transgender patients are men. And I think they feel more comfortable with women because they don't get the male bashing they would get mm-hmm. from other male surgeons. And they feel more comfortable with a female surgeon. So I started getting a lot of transgender patients that way.
When did you start doing transgender patients?
I've been doing, I've been doing cosmetic surgery for over 20 years.
Yeah.
And well, I'll tell you, another reason is because when I did general surgery mm-hmm. residency, and my residency program was actually in what's called the gay ghetto in the city of Philadelphia, so it was the West Hollywood.
Yeah.
So we used to get a lot of the gay community to start with back then, and I was very comfortable with the gay community as a whole at the time. So when I came to L.A. in 1996, back to L.A., in 1996, I just fell right into it. And I was advertising a lot in the gay community, in the gay papers. Mm-hmm. And they just started coming to me. And I think it was about 18 years ago when I started doing a lot of transgender surgeries themselves.
Can you describe, like, the process of doing, like, the transgender surgery? Like, how, you know, you go into, like, making a man, or, you know, or like their parts?
The transgender surgeries I do is not the sex change operation.
Yeah.
I basically do more of the cosmetic surgeries that have nothing to do with the private parts.
Oh, so you just do like the breast?
I do the breasts. Uh-huh. For example, male to female.
Yes.
Usually it is to feminize a male's features on the face.
Mm-hmm.
So it usually includes obviously getting rid of the apple, the Adam's apple, making the nose much more feminine and smaller, mm-hmm. sometimes adding a chin implant, cheek augmentation, adding some fillers or cheek implants to the cheek. Obviously, you're doing the eyelids. Usually those are for men. And then, obviously, breast implants, fat injections, or buttock implants into the hips and into the buttocks. That's for the men. For the women, it's usually just mainly breast reduction.
Okay, so going back to, like, the males, you know, when the guy is transitioning into a female, when you talk about, like, the apple Adams, how do you do that? Like, you know, is it shaved off? Like, how do you remove it?
Yeah, you can remove it, but it's much easier to just shave off a piece of it.
Oh.
There's a very small incision that I make.
Yeah.
It's about a centimeter and a half of an incision, and it's just a cartilage. So it's similar to, you were earlier talking about the ear.
Mm-hmm.
It's similar to the ear cartilage. So it's just a piece of cartilage that you just remove or shave off.
What's the purpose of the apple's Adam then for a man? Then, if you were saying that it's just like a like cartilage that you just shave off,
there actually is no purpose? Use for it. No.
That's interesting.
Same as the appendix.
Yeah,
there is no use for it at all.
Now, is it painful? You know, once like they have it shaved off, you know, like the recovery process of the apple Adam.
The Adam's apple, the removal of it or the shaving of it doesn't really hurt. Usually with any surgery, most of the pain you have is just from the incision side. It's just a slight burning sensation, mm-hmm. which is for the first day or two.
Now, you were talking about also doing like the eyelids. Like what, how do you change the eyelids, you know, from a guy to looking like a woman? Like what do you do? I didn't know that they did the eyelids.
The eyelids for men are usually, the male eyelids are usually lower than the female eyelids.
Uh-huh.
So you just elevate it or lift it, the crease line.
Yeah.
You just lift it to give it more of a feminine look.
So it's kind of like when, you know, we females get older, how it kind of like...
The hooding.
Yeah. So yes. That's what that is. Okay.
Correct.
Yeah.
The nose obviously is just to... feminize it more, make it thinner, shape it a little bit more differently.
And then you said also you do like implant, like butt implants?
Yes. The female pelvis or the female butt is more rounded out mm-hmm. than the male. And men usually don't have hips whatsoever.
Yeah.
So to transition them into a woman, they usually add fat or do augmentation with prosthesis or with silicone implants.
Now, when you do like for the butt, do you do the kind where you inject it, you know, where you like do a, you know, like a hole and you put stuff in it? Or is it, do you add you like can, an implant?
You can do either one. It depends if the person has fat or not.
Mm-hmm.
If there's fat, the easier way is to just do fat. And in women or in men, both, some people call it Brazilian butt lift. And that's because it was started in Brazil.
Yeah.
But, and it's just basically taking out the fat. The Brazilian butt lift literally means to take the fat from the lower back and cleaning it and processing it and putting it into the buttocks. I do usually, the liposuction I do is actually all around the upper body, meaning the upper abdomen, the lower abdomen, the entire back, and mm-hmm. then I add the fat to the buttocks. Most of the time, it's not all the fat because it's too much fat.
Now, with the process for that, you know, like for a guy, when they do that, is there like any type of, like any type of precautions? Like they're not supposed to sit down for a while?
Yes, for any patient that has either fat or any implant placed into the buttocks,
mm-hmm.
I actually do not allow them to lie down on their buttock or on their back for the first 10 days.
Wow.
It's pretty painful. So it's sort of like doing a breast implant and sleeping on your breasts.
Oh, yeah.
So think of it. So that's the reason. So I tell them not to basically, they have to lie down on their stomach for the first 10 days. And when they sit down, they're usually supposed to sit down on something very fluffy. So usually a very comfortable pillow would be nice.
Mm-hmm.
And it's better not to sit down for long periods of time, meaning, you know, just eat, drink, and then go back to lying down.
Why is that? Like if they sit down for a long period, does that have any impact on where the fat's going to go?
It's very painful. And B, I don't want the fat to transfer anywhere.
Okay.
So it could move around. Now, some doctors, when they put the fat in,